Good evening, everybody. First and foremost, I am obviously back home finally, so back to making videos at home, and in addition to actually having things to make videos of because I'm at home. I thought about doing an actual car update video today, but quickly realized daylight was running out and projects were still piling up. As always when I'm at home, I came home Tuesday, today is Sunday night, and I don't think I've gone to bed any earlier than 1 a.m., since Tuesday night being here, just because, and that's how it's always been when I'm at home, is I just, you know, I get caught up in projects. I'm like, oh, let's do this. Oh, let's do that. Like, oh, I got time to do this, you know, or, oh, I want to get this done today. So yeah, I'm back home. That's the first and foremost, most important thing. The next important thing, order of business, well, that technically was a car update, but that didn't happen. The following, matter of business is something not for the faint at heart. If you're one of those that needs to wax one off when you see a bunch of vacuums, you might want to prepare for that now. And that's because I picked up all this shit today. Shit is in vacuum cleaners, vacuum cleaners, vacuum cleaners, vacuum cleaners. My neighbor came over, counted close to 50. That's I put the number between 40 and 50. These came from a guy that I met. This had to have been back when I was living with my mom, so that would have been 2013, 2012. I met him through an ad he put on Craigslist for selling vacuums. Bought multiple machines from him over the course of several years. Got a couple machines for other collectors from him. Got a bunch of machines for free from him. And at this point, these are all... we're all free. He's been sort of forced to get the house cleaned up because it's in major disrepair. Apparently his sister's in charge of the house, or it's her house or something, and she's like, get this shit out of here because I need people to come in and fix it. And in addition to, he's really tired of dealing with the vacuums, hasn't touched them in years, wants to focus on his TV and vintage audio repair. And says he can't get to a lot of the stuff he wants to because the vacuums are in the way. So I'm like, well, I will take whatever you want. And he kind of threw in there that at some point he'd like to talk some light monetary compensation for some of the better machines. So anyway, yeah, picked up this big-ass lot, piled him in my truck, had him rolling. He was very skeptical of it not fitting. I said, I will pack them. I am Sanford and Sons reincarnated. Oh, where do we start? I guess we start with the three machines I finished first. This Mega Boss I had wanted to buy from him, but I couldn't justify spending $25 for a machine with a ripped bag. Of course, I gave it a once-over because... And he cleans his machines, but, you know, of course, you know, they're not polished. They've been sitting at least for 3 years now. It might have been four since the last time I was there. So, I mean, like, the Eureka, the belt, was new, but completely dry-rotted and shot, so that had to go. Didn't know we had a Legacy 740 before. I'm getting closer to that 730. I got an 810. I got three Legacy 2s, and now I have a 740. This machine was good to go. Needed a headlight bulb. I think that was it. And of course, I polished it because it wasn't polished. This was one he said he picked up more recently. And so I got it from a funeral home. Had a shakeout bag, obviously. And we'll make it look a little better on camera there. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Shines right up. Didn't even have to put some spit on there. But anyway, he said this is one he picked up more recently and was about to keep it, and they said, oh, hell, get rid of that fucking hammerhead. Of course, I had no problems taking it. And I'm pretty certain the only thing wrong with it was that shakeout bag has a hole in it. So I dug up in the attic space here, knew I had a F&G bag or two, and that lovely gray bag works fantastically for what this thing will do. It has a VG1 brush roll in it, which is a nice choice. What's next? This cool little thing, I doubt it's going to work, but it's, basically a cordless power-headed stick vac, from like the 80s. I have it charging. We'll see. He said years ago it worked, but I mean, that's years ago. You know, the batteries are probably long past toast. I think I have a convertible like this. I don't know. Most of these machines were sitting in his basement with lots and lots of moisture. So pretty much anything metal in the machines is near shot or going to need some serious TLC, brush roll bearings, motor bearings, fans, you know, any moving parts. are going to need a triple over to run. Yeah, so anyway, these were machines he didn't want to sell before. Was holding on to them for dear life, but he said they had to go. I've yet to turn them on, but these were upstairs, so I don't think there's anything wrong with them. Panasonic, another brush roll sees. That Panasonic is good to go. Minus the cleaning and find where the brush plate went. It's around here somewhere, hopefully. This Singer, I think this Singer is missing a brush roll. Most of these machines I got the parts for. Oh no, this one's good to go. Just needs a cleaning and probably a belt because of sitting downstairs. This thing, I don't know what's up with this thing, but I think it's in better shape than mine. So I might sell mine. I don't know. This machine, I think he said, was a customer that brought it in, said it needed, or the bag needed to be repaired because it was blowing dust out, and he came back and told him the fan's destroyed, the bag is destroyed, and I guess the guy gave it to him to get rid of. So I'm assuming it needs a fan based on what he said. Kenmore model convertible, I think, based on that color scheme. I'm going to assume the brush roll. Oh, brush roll is free, so this machine probably runs. Dirty ass Eureka, obviously not the right bag on it. No, this was an upstairs machine. Looks like it needs a belt, at least. This thing is missing brush roll and brush plate. That's great. I don't have that. And a cord. 10.5 amps. Can't ever say I saw that. This machine, oh, I don't know. I might end up keeping this. I don't know. I really don't think I need another Victory. Phantom is pretty beat up. Probably a sale machine. Yeah, so you're looking at this now. I'm not going to go through all these machines one by one here. That's what future videos are going to be for. I'm going to be straight and to the point here. Pretty much everything from here, the exception of maybe that convertible. Probably this convertible. Probably that Eureka, because I'm pretty certain I have one of those. Maybe my Power Clean. Is that a Power Clean? I thought it was called the Pure Air. Maybe mine, and what else we got here? Probably these two Victories, probably this Phantom, all of these vacuums here, these two Bissells, that Bissell, what's that? A Hoover Quick Broom, Eureka Power Broom, some newer bagless Eureka, the fuck is this thing called? I don't know what this thing's called, but I have one in red just like that. The Vision. The floor cleaners I'm probably going to toss. This Eureka, whatever the heck that thing is. Ultima, I think. Should be an Ultima, yeah. Hoover 68, I think this is. Sharp. Oric. No, not the Oric. Anyway, all the machines I just mentioned and you've just seen, those are pretty much immediately up for sale. Before or after I go through them, I really don't care. I can probably almost guarantee any machine at this point is going to need brush roll service of some type, a new brush roll, re-greased, cleaned up, something like that, based on from where they were. I know this is going to kill some of you, your hearts at least, but pretty much everything you're looking at here, these Dirt Devils and Bagless Bissells, are going to be stripped and tossed. So unless you need like a hose or a cord clip or a wheel or something, don't bother asking me to sell them. I do not have time for that. Hoping that that Kenmore with the big ass pain in the ass brush roll in it, that thing works. Older Hoovers, there's no killing those, so those will probably work. And then, pretty much everything else we're looking at on like this section here, I plan on keeping minus the few that I mentioned. And then everything in front of the Isuzu here, probably even this wide path, but I think that's missing multiple things, is for sale. At this point, I'm sure many have seen the post I made 2 months ago about getting rid of the collection. I've kind of modified that. There was a moment, while I wasn't home, I had a, I guess, I knew it was going to happen. I was going to come home and not be able to get rid of my shit as much as I wanted to when I wasn't here. But there are some definite machines I've had on my mind to get rid of first before I consider depleting the actual collection, such as the duplicates or all the vacuums that are upstairs there in the attic. They had to have been there since I moved in because they weren't fit for the collection, nor did I have room. It's been 2 years now. I don't ever foresee them joining the collection. It's time to go. So off the top of my head, I know I have I think the thing's a true clean. It's the same as that yellow one. That fucker's mint. That's definitely for sale. That yellow one, I think, is in good shape, except it's missing a handle release. What else is up there? There's a couple machines up there. And then, like, anything I have, anything that's here that's a duplicate of what I already have, really don't have a reason to keep it, except maybe the Phantom, but this Phantom's in kind of sad shape, at least physically looking at it. And then, like, this thing, I know mine's in better shape. Mine was, like, brand new when I got it. I don't really have a reason for another one. If somebody wanted this, I'd probably replace that if I could. But, yeah, that's keep that in mind. Anybody wants something here, minus that pile there. I'm not bothering with that pile. It's not worth. I don't care if you have $1 million. I really don't see why you'd spend $40 to ship a $20 vacuum. So anyway, I guess that's all there is to say here. When I go in the house soon, I'm hopefully going to do introduction videos of these. I know it's like 11:30 tonight, but that doesn't stop me. I'm going to try, because this is a goddamn disaster. I created it. I can't say anything. I'm going to try to wean out some of these scrap vacs to give myself some space to work here. And then head inside and do the other videos. And that is it for now.